artist Samuel DeLange. How does it feel to have won the BMO art competition?
Yeah, it's really exciting. It's been a busy couple months getting prepared for all this, and it's been exciting. I mean, just having that kind of exposure on a national level is something that, you know, right out of school kind of helps build that momentum, and it's been a lot of fun. Yeah.
And here's your beautiful piece right behind us. Tell me a little bit about the materials you used to create it.
So it's made using expired stocks of Polaroid film, but peel apart Polaroid. So before, in like the pre-digital sort of era, you'd have these peel apart Polaroids that you could peel apart, and on one side you'd have a print, and on the other side you'd have a negative, and you could take that negative kind of into the darkroom and print with it. But because this film was so old, it couldn't really hold an image anymore, the negative, so it would continually kind of develop and grow until it sort of exhausted itself into a sort of abstract composition like we see here. And so the actual negative is about 4 inches by 5 inches, a little smaller. And then I took that into the digital darkroom and scanned it and enlarged it to a larger scale, kept the same ratio. And then these little details of sort of growth and decay, they become, you can really sort of imagine into them. So that was the technical process anyways, yeah.
And has film always been something that's been interesting to you? You know, why did you start getting into that in the first place?
Well, it's kind of a long story. I'll try to give you the short version. But I was kind of trained as maybe a more traditional kind of photo documentary, was what I was originally kind of interested in, maybe pre-art school. But then I had this experience where I was traveling and I had a camera go missing. I got stolen with all the images and stuff like that.
No!
So all these images, I know, it was horrible. It was horrible. But then 8 months later, this interesting thing happened, and I found this kind of specialized search software that could find all the images on the internet taken with that camera. And so I'd been able to download all these images that, you know, the camera's new owner had been uploading onto Flickr and stuff like that, which was kind of really weird. And I think that for me in the last year, I mean, this happened about 2 years ago, but it sort of shaped my practice for the last 2 years because it sort of changes the way I think about photography as a kind of ecology. And so I kind of wanted to challenge that and question that and sort of make a space in which you could kind of question that. So I started using these more analog kind of photo processes. And I think the kind of abstract nature, you know, and the void and the title a little bit allows you to imagine in, because photography is such a sort of integral part of our day-to-day existence, that to be able to question that by using some not even that old technology, I think is kind of interesting. So.
Mm-hmm. And where's the best place for us to follow you and your art online?
I know, I'm bad for online. I just started up a website, SamuelDeLange.com. So you can check me out there, and I'm going to try to keep it updated. And yeah, there's usually some links to blog postings and things like that when I get fortunate enough to be written or talked about online. So,
mm-hmm. Well, thank you so much. Congratulations on being the national winner, and I'm excited to follow your career.
Fantastic. Thank you. This is awesome. Yeah.
I'm Katie Allman reporting for Katie Chats at MoCA in downtown Toronto.